What we're going to do is we're going to let you guys run the art thing, the art program, and all I'm going to do is just have you guys get started. Your job today is to work together to create a covered wagon train of which each of you have your own wagon. Give everybody one piece of paper, please. This is my piece of paper. With your ruler and light pencil mark, I'm using heavy. Do not mistake it. I'm using heavy so you can all see. Using light pencil, I want you to put the end of your ruler right at the edge of your paper. And I want you to go up 3 inches. That's all. Just 3 inches and put a pencil mark. If one of the helpers, if you go back and make sure that they know what 3 inches is for those students who might not know what it is. Yes. Leaving your mark there, I'm at 3 inches here. I'm going to want 3 more inches up. And what will that be?
6 inches.
6 inches. So at the 6-inch mark, put another pencil mark there. We're doing art together. We have these relationships they have. We have math and art that we just put together, right? Do the same thing to the other side. Okay, let me do mine. Are we in right brain or left brain right now?
Right brain.
Thank you.
We're left brain because we're talking and we're doing with numbers. On the very top mark, which is the top 6-inch mark, watch this. I just want you to do this. And then let it exit right off there. Don't be worried about how it looks. I don't care how it looks. I care that you just work with this right now and let it flow. At the 3-inch mark, not at the bottom of the page. You have another pencil mark here. You should have only one other pencil mark. Now, all you do is just do it again, and it doesn't matter. You can come around like this, but try to keep this approximately 3 inches away. So, tell me some things we're going to draw on this. Just raise your hand. What?
Covered wagon.
A wagon. If you have a Conestoga, you have to draw ox. If you have a prairie schooner, you're going to have to draw horses. Go around a Conestoga. On a Conestoga, what are we going to use?
Ox.
Ox. A couple ox. People.
Cargo.
Maybe hanging cargo on the outside. What's the very first thing that wagons need?
A wheel.
Wheels. So let's do wheels.
Okay.
What's the next thing I need?
Wagon.
Your wagon.
The box. The wagon box. Okay. Now what?
The canvas.
By the way, the reason why they call it a prairie schooner, a schooner is a ship that's out on the water that you see from a distance in a sail. And when you go across the prairie, the grass waves back and forth, and this looks like the big sail of a ship. It looks like a big row of ships. What else?
Horses.
What? Horses. Oxen. All right, now, listen. I'm not going to laugh if you don't laugh. Okay, here we go. So let me draw oxen real quick. Legs. All right, big legs. Big body. Now remember, I'm going quick. Think about where you're at. Okay, here. I'm trying to get this done so we have time. Big oxen right here. Big leg here. And a bridle on the oxen. Okay. You notice I'm more worried about the concept. I'm not worried how it's going to look. Okay. Next.
People.
Okay, so here's the people. Have someone up here driving. This is who? On what book? Little House on the Prairie. Very good.
Oh, I never heard that book.
Except they have.
Your task is to do it with marker in 20 minutes. Okay? Black line your pencil. Absolutely perfect.
That is just absolutely heartbreaking. That's so pretty. Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
Hello, my name is Marcia Ostrink, and I'm the creator of Arts Attack, an entire art curriculum on video for the elementary school. Right from the beginning, dating back to 1979, this program was designed to fill a need, to provide a solution to a problem, the lack of commitment to the arts in the elementary school, resulting in little or no art in the classroom. So I decided to treat art as core curriculum and create a developmental sequential art program based on teaching art elements and art principles. We also focused on right brain drawing and the lives and styles of the great artists, art history, and multicultural art. By 1991, I had been giving teacher training workshops for a number of years, and I realized that I was hearing teachers say over and over again that they didn't feel prepared to teach art. So I decided to take this time-tested program and put it on video to provide a teaching tool for the classroom teacher, the parent volunteer, or the art specialist. Today we're going to talk about a famous artist, and her name is Georgia O'Keeffe. She painted other things too, but she wanted you to see flowers up close. She said, you know, people don't pay attention to flowers because they're so small. So I will paint them big. I will paint them so big that everybody will see them. Let's look at this painting that she did, and it's all white. It's a white flower. Isn't that wonderful, the way you can see all the edges of the petals? She changed the colors, didn't she, a little? She made some areas darker, and some areas lighter. Right in the center of the flower, you can see all the details. But right now, I'm going to look at what's inside the flower, and with my crayon, I am going to draw what I see, every little detail. Now, I see some little fuzzy, like they're almost like little curlicues and fringes down in my rose. And I'm going to outline everything with my crayon. Now I am going to see all these petals. Do you think that you could draw every one of them? Well, you can try. All you have to do is draw the outside of the petal the way you see it. And I will do mine quickly here because I know you're waiting and anxious to get started. So I'm trying not to miss one edge. I'm trying to draw every single one. Now the important thing today is that you go all the way off your paper, because look how Georgia O'Keeffe worked. She went off the edges of her paper. So I'm trying to draw every petal I see, and see how they overlap, and it fills up the whole paper.
I'd like to now introduce Candy Glendinning, who was a volunteer in the Arts Attack program.
Hi, Candy.
Hi.
Why did you volunteer to be involved in the Arts Attack program at Smiley School?
Well, I was looking for an opportunity to work with my son's class and somehow volunteer my time and add to the whole experience that the kids get. You know, the teachers try to cram in a whole bunch of, you know, reading, writing, and arithmetic every day. And I just wanted to be able to help add a whole nother layer of education to their classroom experience.
Actually, I was asked by Louise. School was getting very close to the beginning, the start of school, and Louise said she needed someone to chair the Arts Attack show. And since I love art, and art has always been a big part of my life, whether it be drawing or music, I said, sure, I'll do it. Because I feel it's very important for the kids to have an opportunity to express themselves.
Well, I'm a former elementary school teacher, and I know the importance of art. And as the government has changed and the laws have changed and the teachers have so much responsibility to teach standards-based education, that the art has left education right now. And I'm an advocate of art, and I know how art increases creativity and intelligence in children. So I've do anything to advocate art at my children's school.
How did you learn about the program?
Well, the PTA spent a whole year auditioning different arts enrichment programs, and they would send little notices home in the backpack. So I got the notice in the backpack that came home from school, and I took my son, and we went to a two-hour introduction to Arts Attack that was given by the woman who's designed the program. And we got to hear her discussion of the philosophy of Arts Attack, and then the parents and kids together actually did a little mini Arts Attack lesson. And we got to see how the program would actually work in the classroom.
I learned of the program through Louise, who told me that she needed someone to head up or chair the Arts Attack show. And I said, I'll do it.
Louise Hewitt is our PTA president, and at one of the meetings she explained to all of the parents what Arts Attack was and then solicited for volunteers. And then she did a private meeting with the parents who were wanting to be volunteers and explained it further, and that's how I heard about Arts Attack.
What did you do to help the program succeed?
Well, I was involved in two different ways. The first way is I was a docent in my son's class last year, and so once every other week I'd go in the morning and meet with Mrs. Adama, and we would set up the lesson during the kids' first recess, and then she would spend about an hour and a half doing a lesson, and I would just basically be there with Mrs. Adama circulating with the kids and encouraging them, you know, oh, think about this texture, or what do you want this line to do, and basically just trying to encourage the kids to do the point of the lesson. So Louise asked me to help out on the sort of the organizational level. So I coordinate the docents, which is basically just keep a database of all the different parents who have said that they're going to volunteer and what classroom they're going to volunteer from, and make sure that we've got a docent for each classroom so the teacher has someone to call upon to ask for help. I also help organize the carts. We have these huge carts with all these different media in them, all, you know, paints, charcoals, glue, and enough for all the students in the class. It's very organized. And so I've got a whole database of what should be on the cart and, you know, how much of each one should be in that cart depending upon what grade you're in. And so I keep that all organized, and I help keep the carts restocked with all the stuff. And so a teacher can call me and say, oh, I need some more red paint, or I need some more paper plates, and I'll just go and just shove it in the cart so that it's always stocked and ready to go. So I've been kind of involved on that level as well.
I made portfolios, about 200 portfolios. Louise and Candy and I each took a group of kids, and we made portfolios. I believe each of us probably did 200 to 300 portfolios. Then once a month, either I or Louise or Candy would go collect all the artwork from the teachers. Then we would file the artwork. We'd call some volunteers, they'd come in and do some filing, or we'd file ourselves. We had a lot of help with the volunteers. They were very helpful. And then once we collected the artwork, and when it got closer to the show, there were two shows, actually. And we collected, from all the artwork we collected, we picked one piece that we felt, one or two pieces that we felt would be the best artwork of the student. And you could wander up and down the aisles and the kids would feel this sense of pride as they saw their artwork displayed on these gallery walls. It was so fun to watch the parents and the kids walk up and down and see the excitement on the child's face showing off their piece of work that they did.
Well, since the program is a volunteer-based program, I volunteered at least once a week, sometimes twice a week, and I volunteered in my children's classes, but I also found out that there were some teachers that didn't have any parent volunteers in their classroom, and so I was able to go into those classrooms and just kind of reteach the lessons I had already taught in my children's classes in those classes as well.
What did you learn from this experience?
Well, first of all, I have not had any formal arts training, and on a personal level, it's really neat to see the implementation of all the different aspects of art and how you can talk about them in simple terms and have the kids understand them. And, you know, I actually realized that there, you know, you have to think about line, contour, shading, texture, color. And so it's been really fun to actually be exposed to a bit of, you know, true artistic training, which I've never had. I didn't have anything like this in school. So that on a personal level has been fun for me to see that. It's also been great to see the kids really get focused and involved in a project and not be looking at the clock. Oh, is it time for recess? Is it time for lunch yet? You know, when we do Arts Attack, you know, I walk in the door, they are excited. Oh, there's Liam's mom. We're going to do Arts Attack. They get all excited. They're happy, happy, happy. And then we go, and you know, this lesson will go on for quite a while. And they really, they stay focused, they stay on task, and they really have a lot of fun creating something that is more art than craft, which I appreciate. You know, you can only have so many turkeys drawn with outlines around the kids' hands, you know? So we're trying to get them to think on a higher level. And it's been really neat to see that. They enjoy it, and they're really having a true enrichment experience, I think, which makes me happy.
Well, actually, I never was able to study art in school or in college. And so as the art program has been going along, I've gotten to learn some art techniques. And it's a nice thing about the program because you don't need to know art to teach art. Although the benefit is that I get to learn a little bit more art and then bring that back into my home and my family and my own personal self. And that's a joy.
Overall, what's your opinion of this program?
I think for a program that was designed to introduce visual artistic concepts into the classroom without having to have a full-time art teacher on, you know, on staff, on location, I think this is the perfect way to do it. I think it's got great continuity, and I'm very excited to see the art that we get from the kids who started this program last year in kindergarten. I cannot wait to see what we get from the fifth graders who have been through 5 or 6 years of Arts Attack training. I'm very excited, and I think we'll see a level of sophistication in the visual art that you wouldn't normally see from a fifth grader. So I'm very excited about that because it does truly emphasize the aspects of design and in the visual arts in such a way that with the repetition, the kids are really going to start to understand these underlying artistic concepts.
I feel that we've lost something in our schools taking away the art and music. I feel this is a fabulous program because it shows so many other schools how important art is to our students, to enable them to be successful in life at anything they do. Art is so diverse. You know, they say we need math, they say we need reading, tons of reading, lots of writing. That's fabulous. But there's also different forms of language and art as well. You can apply all those things to art. And art, like I said before, allows the mind to open up to other areas that enable politicians to be successful and run our country as well, that enable mathematicians to do what they do. It opens your mind to an abstract way of thinking. It allows the person to become more emotional if it's relating to something personal. It allows a society to be more connected because each person sees something in the art that relates to them. So if you take away art, you just have some mindless robots that do what they're programmed to do. Well, art allows them to think individually. So my opinion is that it allows the school to be successful because it allows the children to be successful, not only in school, but in life and in our future.
I think the program is a great program. In fact, I think it's so great that I'm going to be taking care of the program and integrating it again into the school next year. I believe that art is incredibly important for development of children. It's successful. There's been studies that show that it's great for kids' emotional health and creative health. And I think that any school that could find an arts program like this or like another program, it would be successful, especially if it's volunteer and parent run.
With me today is Louise Hewitt, who was one of those people who brought about change. Hi, Louise.
Hi, David.
Can you describe the condition of the art offerings at Smiley Elementary School when you arrived there in 2001?
When we first arrived, there really wasn't much of an art program at Smiley. I was surprised to find that really the only art education that they got was if they were lucky enough to have an art specialist appointed to the school, which would be for one trimester for the year.
What inspired you to change the art curriculum at Smiley School?
I was fortunate enough to attend a PTA conference, and at that conference I learned about the Arts Attack program. The Arts Attack program was a series of videotapes that presented an arts lesson in its entirety. An art teacher would stand up and take the lesson on the video, and a model classroom would be shown demonstrating the lesson. It seemed very much to be a program that would fit well with our circumstances, in that teachers are not really experienced with art education. They are usually intimidated at the prospect of teaching art with children. So we knew it had to be something that wasn't going to rely on the teachers for their knowledge or their experience or their confidence. This was a program that was video-based. The instruction was entirely delivered by an art professional, and the teachers really just had to support that tape and help implement the lesson. Primarily, before we even considered purchasing the program, we had to ensure that we had the support of the staff. So we took the program to the staff, we presented it, we had people from Arts Attack come out to provide information on the program, how it operated, show sample videos, and the response from the teachers was really, really positive. We had been concerned because, of course, any new program that we introduce is necessarily going to cut into their academic instruction time. Once we knew that they had their support, we approached the Redlands Art Association to see if they were able to help us with funding the program. They agreed to fund the entire program, so that enabled us to purchase the videotapes, the teaching manuals, the art study prints for every grade in the school. The PTA then used its fundraising money that they had raised through various fundraisers to purchase the art equipment.
Why add art at all to the curriculum?
Children need to have creative experiences. They need to have experiences that are open-ended, that allow for a multitude of response styles. They need to have experiences where they can utilize their imagination.
What educational or other experience helped you to implement change?
I think having a teaching background came in handy because I knew where the teachers were coming from. It's easy for me to sort of talk to the teachers and to know their limitations, their constraints, the things that are concerning them, so I could relate from their position. So that was, and I also, I mean, I guess I had the confidence to interact with the teachers, which was important because the implementing the program has required a lot of liaison between the PTA, the parent body, and the teachers to ensure that everybody knows what's going on, everybody's on the same page with the programs. Having particularly an education background in early childhood education, where the developmental nature of children is so important to us.
Did the being a PTA president give you any edge in being successful in this task?
By being PTA president, it wasn't just me as a parent coming in saying, well, you should do something. It was me coming in saying, you should do something and I'm going to help you to do it. And I have the funding to help you to do it. And I have the expertise to help you to do it.
How is it structured and how did you adapt to it?
I think any pre-made curriculum that comes from anywhere can never be suited to every group of children or to every individual child or every individual setting. So you need to be confident that, you know, you can adapt something, and it has lent itself very well to those sorts of adaptations.
How did you get the teachers involved?
I think fundamental to everything we did had to be the assurance that this would require no additional work from them other than giving us that lesson time.
What was the role of the parent volunteers and coordinators?
Our parent volunteers serve in the way they feel comfortable. So if they have limited experience, they may just be responsible for preparation of materials and cleanup and helping the children with the lesson. The parents who are more capable or confident or perhaps have a teaching background, they often team teach with the teacher to conduct the lesson, or they may conduct the lesson in its entirety and the teacher acts as a support person.
Did this new program present any physical issues or problems?
Particularly in the upper grades, and we have 36 children on desks, which are sort of this big, painting on basically 18 by 24 inch paper. That's a challenge. It does pose difficulties for schools that don't have big space. For the most part, I think having the mobile art carts has certainly headed off a lot of potential problems that we could have, because the materials are always on hand. They're not having to, we have an art storeroom that we have established at the rear of the cafeteria that holds just collage materials and printing ink that aren't needed on a regular basis.
How did you raise the money for equipment and art supplies?
We had family fun nights that we would have materials, promotional materials available on the program. We had the Arts Attack people provided us with videos of artwork and art shows that had been held at other schools so that we could be showing parents of, you know, this is what we're working towards. We also had a very successful family fun night where we had an art night for the families. And we set up a range of stations which had various open-ended art experiences. And we also had artists from the Redlands Art Association come along and demonstrate some of their crafts. So we had a gentleman come along and do caricatures of the children. That was our sort of the link between art in the community and sort of professional artists and the art program that we were hoping to introduce. So we basically saturated the school with art and art education and art in the community. And in that way, parents knew that the money they were raising was going to this program and that there was, we had a long-term goal in mind.
What were the benefits that were supplied to the students in this program?
The program benefited the students on a number of levels, actually, and the benefit, I think, varied according to their age group. In the kindergarten class, we noticed that the children's ability to focus, their ability to attend to instructions and follow instructions, their ability to sustain concentration over a period of time was greatly enhanced. When it came to the older children, we found that we had a different problem in that the older children had been through four years of academic instruction, and they were very much of the mindset that there was only one correct answer to everything. So when they would do their artwork, it was very much, have I done it right? Is that okay? You know, is that what you want? Is mine good? Do you like it? You know, it was less art for themselves than, okay, I'm just doing this for you and let me know when I've got it right. So we had to break down that mentality, and that was difficult. And towards the end, we found that the children were getting much better at being less critical and much more, you know, happy with their own work and realizing that they were doing this for themselves, and if they were happy with it, then that was what was important. So that was certainly a challenge for them to overcome, and it was certainly a skill that you could really see develop over time with the children. Through this program, the children were able to draw these incredible products, and it's still, although there was a lot of guidance and direction in terms of this is how you go about drawing, this is how you go about representing something on a page or using this technique, there was still a lot of freedom for children to interpret those things on an individual basis. I think the children themselves were amazed at the products that they produced. And I think if we want to produce children who are thinking individuals, we need to give them these sorts of opportunities to express themselves in an individual manner, because that's the only way we're going to get thinking, creative people who can solve the problems of the years ahead of us, is to have children who are able to think differently and look at things differently. And I think art is a great media for getting children, developing those skills in children and letting them see things a little bit differently.
How did the students respond to this program?
The children responded extremely well to the program. If there is no other justification for this program, the most crucial one has to be that for 1 hour a day, the children were able to relax and enjoy themselves. School shouldn't be a stressful experience. School should not be about just hammering stuff into kids' heads. School should be about children enjoying themselves. School should be a place children look forward to going to. And I think the way our curriculum is going at the moment, for a lot of children, it's not something that they look forward to.
Now that the first year is completed, in what ways was it a success?
I think in terms of the teaching of the curriculum, I think it was a great opportunity for the teachers to develop their familiarity with the curriculum and to realise that they could change things and that certain things needed to be adapted. I think the standard of the work that was produced overall was of a very high quality, and I think that in turn further motivated the teachers and the students to really want to be part of this program, because they could see, no, it's not just this school on the video, we can do this too. We can actually produce these incredible works of art with our children with no experience. So I think that was an incredibly affirming experience for them. The art show was a massive amount of work. So this year we've implemented a system where the artwork is stored in the children's classroom. In doing so, they are able to determine that they have collected work from every child in their class, at least one piece. I think we can only get better at what we're doing, and as the teachers feel more confident and more capable, and we get, you know, this year we've got far more parent support than we had last year, because again, they've seen the artwork and they're excited by that, and it's like, wow, look at this fabulous stuff. They've been able to talk to other parents who have been involved and had the reassurance that, you know, no, anyone can do this. You know, you can help with this. You know, you don't need to be an artist. I used to panic that when my involvement ended with this program that it would take a slow slide into death, but I don't feel that anymore. I feel that we have such capable and committed and just people who are so excited and so committed to this program that I think its success is pretty much guaranteed.
How could this program be improved to match your vision for its future?
It's difficult because we are facing educational mandates from people much higher up than the PTA or the teachers or the principals or even the Redlands Unified School District. My vision would be that we would have people who are truly informed about education, making educational policy, that we would have people that have a knowledge of child development making educational policy. This program, whilst excellent, is always going to face difficulties in gaining acceptance and getting a strong foothold in schools, as long as there is so much pressure to exclude everything else in a curriculum apart from academic instruction. It's going to take everyone standing up saying, we won't take this anymore. This is important and we need to do things differently. And I think for my PTA board, If we achieved nothing else in our 2 years of service, then, and we only left this program behind for the school, then I think we achieved a very great thing indeed.
Our next interviewee is Gary Peplow, who's been one of the outstanding teachers in the art program here at Smiley Elementary School.
Who or what got you interested in the Arts Attack program?
Well, Louise Hewitt, when she introduced it through, when she was the president of the PTA, brought it to us and showed it to us as a staff. And we all, you already know that we're overwhelmed in school with all the stuff that the state's putting on us to do and the stuff that needs to be taught. It's really overwhelming. And then to bring something new in, it seemed intimidating to most of us. But when we found out how easy it was based on the materials and the way everything was done, and then when having Louise come in and actually mentor with the rest of her cadre that came through and helped, it was very easy to integrate it into the classroom.
In what way were the lesson plans or the materials, the art materials, helpful in teaching this program?
Teaching art to me was more important than teaching art to the kids, because then I could get a passion myself and then teach it to them. So having Louise in the classroom with me during the first time working with them got me on fire for this stuff. And then the way that we worked together to fit it into curriculum, for example, the lesson you just saw was about wagon trains instead of about a Halloween parade. So what we did was we incorporated the Arts Attack into curriculum, and the next thing you know, we have an effective lesson. But there's something more important than that even, and that's this little baby here. This cart right here is fantastic, because everything a teacher ever needs to teach is just right there within reach. And they keep it stocked for us. So if we're talking about the ability to teach art, setup is a good half portion of it. And then the rest just flows if you can get it set up and you have the knowledge that's provided by the DVDs.
What was your experience like in the classroom?
I learned. And I was learning along with the kids. And the thing that was so cool is that at no time during this whole thing did I look like I had no idea what I was doing. Because the DVDs were right there. I followed along with what they were doing. And Louise and I tag-teamed whenever we were together, because she was my parent last year, or whoever happened to be in here. And we brought our own combined experiences to fill in the gaps that we thought maybe the DVD didn't cover. My students were very successful, and I'm proud of all of them. But there's one in particular that I was thinking about that really applies to what this program is. You have such a varied amount of students, and they all need a different way to release their creativity. And I had particular at this desk one student last year who was really struggling in some of the other academic areas. And Arts Attack gave him a chance to grow. It was a chance for him to say, look what I can do. And amazingly, everybody in the room drew to this student and said, wow, and I've never seen a student beam like that. And so it just is another chance for someone to experience success. I am more than comfortable with Arts Attack. It met all my expectations, more than that. And the reason why is because it taught me a lot about art that I didn't know. And it made me more confident, which made me able to teach art better. And as I taught art better, then the kids enjoyed it, and then they had fun, and they learned more than I had fun. And it was just a great big feedback loop. Here, the kids do all the work themselves. All you have to do is just give them some guidance.
What was it like to be in the Arts Attack program?
Well, I thought it was great and really fun to, like, do art.
Really good, because you could have time with your friends while you're doing art.
It was really fun being with my friends and having the fun of doing it.
It was something that I could really concentrate on and was really fun and just let me not focus on the time, but on what's happening right now.
It was really fun to be in the Arts Attack program, because usually while I was at home, I would have like soccer practice and homework, and I would have to play, and I would have to help my brother with his homework also. And so I really liked to do it because I usually didn't have time.
It was pretty cool because my mom was the one that founded it. and everybody thought it was great, and everybody was really, when the teacher announced it, they were really glad that they were doing it, and so I think it was really good.
What were your favorite projects?
One of them was on Halloween night when you made like 4 or 5 jack-o'-lanterns, and but first before you glue them on, you made a background, and then you glued on the jack-o'-lanterns.
I liked doing the caterpillar, where you draw lots of things in the circles you did. It was fun.
Doing the koalas and all the animals with the fur sheets and stuff like that.
I would say it was probably making hot air balloons with watercolors. What we would do is we'd make a giant, a big, huge circle on a big piece of paper, and we would draw two lines on the outside and put a little square and make lines in it for a basket. Then we would do the stitch thingies that go in a little bit on the hot air balloon, and then we would color it however we wanted with watercolors.
One of my favorite projects was probably the Enchanted Village, because there was lots of different shapes and designs. We put lots of onion domes on the top of buildings. We made rooftops from Chinatown. And so that was really creative and fun.
Did you save any of your projects? Why or why not?
Between you, me, and the cameraman, I don't remember much of them.
We put them in an art show and we took them home, and we thought how good we were in class.
My mom keeps all of my work and stuff, so we always keep artwork, and I like having like a file of fifth grade work and fourth grade work, and I can look back and say, oh, I remember doing that.
What did you learn about art that you didn't know about before?
I learned a lot of things, like that it can be so fun, and how you, tips on how to draw with watercolors and paints and crayons.
Well, I learned that you could have a lot of fun with it, and you can't really do anything wrong.
That it was really fun, because I didn't have a lot of time to do it, because I had to do my homework a lot.
Do you think it's important to make art in school?
Yes, because sometimes you don't have enough time at home or at wherever else you are, so you can do it at school without anybody interrupting you.
Yes, because usually I don't have time to do my artwork at home or when I'm on vacation or almost anywhere I go, so I like to do it at school.